Hello friends, my name is Sayyid Shahbazali and today I'll show you how to install NSFC01-01A from scratch. But before going towards, please like and subscribe to this channel and don't forget to press the bell icon for more useful videos. Now coming to the topic in which we will see how to do the wiring and the programming of NBSL's door inverter, which is NSFC01-01A. So let's get started. First of all, we will connect the door motor's wires to the terminals on which U, V and W are mentioned. Similarly, we will connect the AC supply of 220V to the terminals where line, neutral and earth are mentioned. And now for the main connections, the first two are the open and close input commands respectively, coming from the elevator's main control, which are responsible to initiate the door opening and closing. Followed by the connections between the inverter and the limit sensors installed at the door tracks. These four sensors are consisted of the door open limit sensor, which is installed at the point where the door is fully opened, close limit sensor, which is installed when the door is completely closed, the open deceleration sensor, which is installed right next to the open limit sensor, and the closed deceleration sensor, which is installed immediately before the door close limit sensor. And the last connection is for the common between all the sensors, the door inverters and the elevator control. Now we will connect the outputs of the door inverter to the elevator control, which is basically the confirmation signal to the main control from the door inverter that the door is either fully opened or closed. For this, we will connect the OPO and CLO to the door fully open and closed output respectively with a common cable that remains separated from the inputs common. And now you can see that we have already installed these four magnetic limit sensors in their positions, which have already been discussed. If you notice a small magnet installed at the door that moves with the door, passing over all the four sensors to activate or deactivate each of them. Since we have completed our connections, now we are moving towards its programming. To begin with, we will set P1 to 1 in order to hold the control, which is required in order to change any of its parameters. Now we will go to N8 to check whether the polarity of the already installed magnetic sensor is correct or not. There will be four vertical LEDs and they have been given the names according to their positions. When the magnet passes over any of such sensor, the corresponding LED is toggled. Currently, all four LEDs are illuminated and the door is fully open, which is incorrect. At this point, only two LEDs should be illuminated, one for the door open deceleration and the other for the door open. So, as to correct this, we will bring the door into the center of these sensors and at the center point, not a single LED should light up. But if it's not happening, we will change the value of P19 to P22 to get the desired status of the LEDs. And now you can see that after setting them, we have been able to get the desired outputs. As we slowly close the door, we can see that the LEDs light up as soon as the magnet crosses its corresponding magnetic switch. and similar will be the case with the door opening. Now we will try it for the first time by giving it an open command from the keypad. If you notice, the door moving at the different speeds frequencies across the display. You can change these speeds using the D1 to D10 parameters. Now let's see how smoothly it is running, both in closing and in power opening. Thanks for watching this video. Give your feedback in the comment sections and suggest the next topic on which you would like to see another tutorial video.